You guys ready to hear a bedtime story? Hi, Rihanna. What do you think of my hat? Hi, Sander and family. You've been trying to see what is 8 times 9? You know what 8 times 9 is. Did you ever figure it out? Maybe your friends can type the answer. Let's see, what is 8 times 9? You're in Mr. Harrison's class? Hello, fifth grader. Hi, Karina. Do you guys like this one? This song? It's my second favorite, I think. I think we should start out the day tomorrow with this dance. Did you ever figure out? Oh, good. Somebody wrote the answer. 8 times 9, 72. You know what? I know what 8 times 10 is. And then I just have to subtract the group. How's that for a helper fact? Okay, kids, pop kids.
That was the best time ever.
Want to keep having the best time ever with us? Just ask Alexa to play Kids Bop.
Ayo, ayo.
Did you guys really think I was saying it? We didn't. We didn't think so. Oh my gosh, you guys, I'm going to level up. I'll wait. Should I? I'm leveling up. I'm sitting here alone leveling up on Go Noodle. Stop, Mrs. Bennett, just stop. Okay, it's 8 o'clock. Who do we have in the house? We have Karina, Rihanna, Ada. Uh-oh, what'd I do? Sander, Sander's your sister with you. Carly, hello, Carly. Hello, Dominic. What's happening? Yes, sister is with Sander. Hi, sis. Oh, look, we're being so supportive in our messages. Good job, Rihanna. Well, do you know why? Do you know why I'm wearing this hat? It has something to do with the story I'm reading. It's a wild thing. Where the wild things are. Have you read this book before? This is like a classic. I love this one. And they turned it into a movie. Only it doesn't take as long to read the book as it does to show the whole movie. They added a lot more in the movie, didn't they? Hi, Dominic. Oh, is that Bailey? Bailey and Kaylee. Hello, girls. Oh, and we have, there's Kaylee. Lexi, are you out there too? Hi, guys. So glad you could join us. We have to get this started because we have to wake up and get ready for action with field day tomorrow. Are you guys looking forward to field day? I am. Ayo, ayo. So tomorrow you're going to be the wild things in field day. You kind of were the wild things today, though, now that I think about it. Mr. Harrison's class, were you the wild things today? My class was a little wild today. You don't want to get wet. You don't have to. I'm not going to make anybody get wet if they don't want to. What's interesting guy's favorite color today, Carly? Oh my gosh, right? Is it purple? Is it orange? I'm so excited to find out. I can't possibly read this until I know, Carly. What is interesting guy's favorite color today? Purple polka dots. Sandra, you're excited for tomorrow? It's going to be so fun. Pink. Pink is interesting guy's favorite color. Maybe, maybe not. Oh, wait. Okay. Wait. Something happened. Somebody sent me a question. Tap a response to show it on screen and share it with your viewers. Is that us guessing? You were good. You guys were good today in Mr. Harrison's class. Oh, sure. Is that what he would say? Just kidding. I believe you. My kids were good too. We were just a little wiggly. If you remember, third graders like to wiggle around a little bit. Okay. I think we should get started on this. What do you think? Yeah, me too. All right. Where the Wild Things Are by Maurice Sendak. It's so exciting already. Where the Wild Things Are. Hello, McKenna. McKenna's on. She just said, hi, Mom. McKenna is watching from work. She just got out of work. McKenna, join. So she's here. Oh, there she said, hi, guys. Sweet. Okay. Where the Wild Things Are. Ooh, which is your favorite wild thing? We'll see. All right, our story begins. The night Max wore his wolf suit and made mischief of one kind. Oh my goodness. Is he hammering nails into the wall? I don't know. It looks like he's making a fort. Looks good to me. Mischievous. And another. Oh, now he's chasing the dog with his fork. He looks pretty serious about getting that dog. His mother called him Wild Thing, and Max said, I'll eat you up. So he was sent to bed without eating anything. Oh, he was grouchy. Hi, Aaliyah. So glad you could join us. We just started, so our little friend in our book, Max, is being sent to his bed because he is grouchy. The very night in Max's room, a forest grew. Oh, well, this is interesting. Wouldn't that be amazing? And grew. This looks fantastic already. And grew until his ceiling hung with vines and the walls became the world all around. Wait, did his bedroom just become outside? Whoa. He looks like a real wild thing now. And an ocean tumbled by with a private boat for Max, and he sailed off through night and day. Wait a second. He went to his room for one night, and already it's been a night and a day? Does he have food on his boat? I would be hungry. And in and out of weeks and almost over a year to where the wild things are. Wait a sec. So weeks went by and even a year on this boat? And what do you think he's thinking when he looks at that wild thing? Maybe he's not feeling so wild. And when he came to the place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws. Let's get close here. Do they look so very terrible? Till Max said, "Be still," and tamed them with a magic trick of staring into all of their yellow eyes without blinking once. And they were frightened and called him the most wild thing of all. Wow, Max has no fear. I am being dramatic. And made him king of all the wild things. "And now," cried Max, "let the wild rumpus start." There's Max being king. What's a rumpus? What's a rumpus? This is a rumpus. What are they doing? Are they dancing in the moonlight like wild things? Oh, they sure are. Are you screaming, Dominic? Oh, look at this. More rumpus activities. It is a party. Swinging on trees. Oh, Max looks like he's having the time of his life. These wild things are not too scary, are they? Oh, does this look like a parade? Oh, look at that. Oh, those wild things look like they love Max. And Max looks very proud. Oh! Does this guy love Max or what? I think so. They are too cute. "Now stop," Max said, and sent the wild things off to bed. Without their supper. Wait, didn't that happen to him? Is he being like his mom? And Max, the king of all the wild things, was lonely and wanted to be where someone loved him best of all. Then all around from far away across the world, he smelled good things to eat, so he gave up being king of where the wild things are. Oh, that's got to be a hard decision. He's going to give up this life of fun because he smells something good? Well, let's see. He hasn't eaten in like a year and weeks and days, right? That's how long he was on that boat, right? You guys, I found a wild thing.
Hi! How is everybody? Is McKenna still here? I'm here in person. I'm here.
I like and don't worry, she smells like a sandwich.
I like your wild thing. Do I?
I'm a wild thing.
You are a wild thing. Hi, Carly.
Yay. Let's get some hearts up there.
Yeah.
I don't know how you guys make that. There they are. Woo! I don't know how you make that happen. I need to figure that out.
When they're watching, there's a little heart, like a like button.
Oh.
You can hit it.
Oh, so I see. It's easy to do. And they're not doing it for me.
Get it.
They're saving it for you.
Did you get some earlier? I was sending in hearts earlier.
Yeah.
Okay.
You sent me. I got one heart.
From me.
Jackson.
Where's McKenna and Jack? I'm right here. Jackson's.
And Sander's saying hello, Sander and his sister.
Hello, Sander and his sister. Oh my gosh, all the wild thing emojis.
Right?
Oh.
Rihanna.
I love you, Rihanna. I love all of you. You guys are so cute.
Wow, look at those hearts.
Yeah.
Maybe we don't even need to finish the story.
Yes,
we'll
yes.
We just sit here and watch the hearts.
No, we're finishing the story because then it's bedtime.
But I'm afraid that he wants to leave the island, and you guys don't want him to leave the island, right? Those monsters are so cute now.
There's only one way to find out. You have to finish the book.
No.
Yeah.
No,
you
we
have
can't.
To.
See? Rihanna said, no, we don't.
No, we don't. Oh, gosh.
When are you coming to class, McKenna?
When am I coming to class, Mom?
When she's not in school. McKenna, can you stay for field day? I wish she could, but she has to go to school.
When is field day?
Tomorrow.
Oh.
And she doesn't even have a green shirt.
I don't.
Oh,
I love you.
Kaylee said I love you, McKenna.
Love you, Kaylee. Everybody watching, I love you. You guys are amazing.
They are amazing, aren't they?
Okay. But I'm going to let you guys finish the book.
No, they're gonna.
Because you guys have to finish the book. Gotta find out the ending. It's only one way, too. So you gotta power through it, people. Yep, finish the story, please. Gotta listen to him.
That's Dom. Dom is, he's like, get on with it.
Yeah. Dom, I agree with you. All right.
Okay, we'll do it.
Good night, everybody. And have a great field day tomorrow. And I will come see you very soon. I love all of you. Good night.
Aaliyah loves you, too.
I love you, Aaliyah. I love
Anna everybody. Ada's saying now.
Oh.
Now it's time to disappoint the children. Go.
I'm sorry.
You guys are so funny. You guys make her feel so loved. And she sure does love you too. Okay, now you're just stuck with me. Woo! I believe we've come to the sad part in the book. So do you have tissues available? Because you might need them. Maybe I need them. Oh, I have this. Here we go. Oh no, there's crying. But the wild things cried, oh please don't go. We'll eat you up, we love you so. And Max said, no. The wild things roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws. But Max stepped into his private boat and waved goodbye. Ooh. He looks happy. They look happy, but they probably don't want him to go. Have you ever had to say goodbye to somebody when you really don't want to go, but you have to? Like, I feel like that when I was playing with my cousins and my mom said, it's time to go. And I'd be like, no, I'm not ready to go. Only this is a little different. These aren't his cousins. These are monsters. They're wild things. And sailed back over a year and in and out of weeks and through a day. Man, so a year there and a year back. Are we going on 2 years now? Is this true? He looks tired. Thank you for my emojis. I love them. And into the night of his very own room, where he found his supper waiting for him. Oh, so maybe he got sent to bed early, but Mom still brought him his food. She understands, I guess, that sometimes we are little wild things. And it was still hot. Look at this illustration. That's amazing. Wait, his food was still hot? But he was gone for like 2 years. How is it still hot? How did he come back on the same night? I have so many questions, you guys. I hope you can help me understand. How is this even possible? Wasn't that a good story? And some of you did see the movie. The movie is really good too. I love all the music in the movie, actually. All the songs are really, really awesome. If you haven't seen it, you should see it. And then we could play the songs in class, because I love them, they're so good. Let's see, what should I have you come tell me tomorrow? I guess, what was the lesson of this story? What was the theme? Who's exaggerating? So if you can come tell me the theme tomorrow, you can dip into the prize box. I think I might owe some of you prizes from last week too. So I guess you'll have to take two. That's too bad. Okay. McKenna come back. He's exaggerating. In the story, he was exaggerating, you think? Like it really wasn't 2 years? It was really just a shorter amount of time. He didn't even leave. Was it all his imagination? I'm so confused. Was there a boat? Did his room really turn into a jungle? You guys have so many questions that need to be answered. I can't wait to hear what your thoughts are. What movie are we going to watch for field day? Good question. We'll look at our options and vote on those. That he left his I'm looking through your messages, making sure I didn't forget. Oh, it was a dream. Oh, you think he fell asleep? Oh, Bailey. If he fell asleep, that would explain if Mom brought the food in and laid it down on the table because he was asleep, and then he woke up. Ooh, I think you are on to something. But isn't it kind of fun to believe that he might have really gone to a magical island where wild things are? What do you think the wild things taught him? And they said they were going to eat him up at the end. Is that a good thing? Somebody says, I'm going to eat you up. Does that mean they're really going to eat you? Or is that something you say? Is that something sometimes parents say to little kids? I love you so much, I'm going to eat you up. I think that could be it too, right? All right, so tomorrow, if you can tell me the theme or the lesson. Yes, Bennett. Are we still doing morning work? Okay, I'll let you guys know. Since you're on here tonight. We are not doing morning work. We will have no time for morning work. We, oh, to be brave. I love that, Sander. Awesome. No morning work. We literally come in. Your shirts are on your desk. You can run to the bathroom to change into those if you need to. If you're just putting them on over your other clothes, you can. And at 8:55, we're lining up. and heading out to field day. So if you're running a little late, you will just find us outside at field day. No big deal. We're wearing green. You can't miss us. All the classes are in different, or all the grade levels are in different colors. So, green. But most everyone's there by 8:55. The color of money. Yeah, we got the color of money. Awesome. All right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed the story. I sure did. And yes, to be brave could be a lesson for sure. All right. So, had super much fun. And I'm really excited for tomorrow, aren't you? And then spring break. Guys, we got this. We got this. Don't leave. Mrs. Bennett has to go to bed because you guys are going to take a great amount of energy tomorrow. You know this, right? Even though he got in trouble, he was still loved. Kaylee, that's going to make me cry. That's so beautiful. Right? it really is a good lesson, right? Even though you get in trouble, you're still loved, and that's really what matters, right? Exactly. All right. I'm so bad at saying goodbye, but I'm going to, because I have to get up early. And you have to get up early. We all have to get up. You guys are going to be wild things tomorrow. I just know it. I'll also tell you about snacks for our movie. That's all I'll tell you. Okay. Peace out, homies. Good night. I'll see you bright and early in the morning, okay? Don't be wild things before bed. Go to bed nicely for your families. Give them extra hugs. And don't wish for a jungle to happen into your room and be sailing off in a boat for weeks and years and days. Okay? Okay. Bye, guys. Bye.